Today we're looking at Marīcyāsana D. It's the fourth Marīcyāsana posture in this sequence, and it's a really, really fun pose, but it can be very challenging. We're going to look at several different variations of the posture for those of you who have to work a little bit more to open your hips and your pelvis so you don't damage your knees. And we're going to go through each variation until we get to the final expression. So let's dig in. From a seated position, we always start with our right side, but in this posture, we begin by bringing our left foot into half lotus. Now I want to quickly remind everybody, just like Marichyasana B, if your hips are really tight, when you first start this pose, it might be beneficial for you to take the variation where you bring your left leg right below your right knee, palms are to the floor, lifting your chest, lengthening your spine, really grounding through your right foot. Take five deep breaths in both sides and vinyasa between sides. So if you've gotten further along in the pose, we're gonna now bring that foot all the way up into half lotus. You always wanna make sure that your toes don't come past your thigh. That puts way too much pressure on your knee. So bring that foot in so it's nestled and nice and tight. And then we're gonna drag the right foot up. The first thing to really focus on here, don't sink back into your body. You want to lift up and forward. So this is a very deep stretch for your foot and your shin. So I always encourage students who still have tightness in their hips to first learn how to lift up and balance on your left glute. Kind of wrap your arms around your legs, sit up tall. This is a great option or variation when you're really first beginning this posture. You're going to take five deep breaths here. Try to squeeze your back. Bind your hands and really work to squeeze your inner left thigh, and you're pushing your left foot into your inner right thigh. If you're back here, it's going to be a lot harder to bind in the posture. So play with this variation to begin with. It's challenging all by itself. After your fifth breath, release. If you like, you can step your feet back and take our vinyasa. And once we come through, we're gonna come right into our left side, bringing your right foot into half lotus. Again, check where your toes are. Bring that left foot up. Most of us are kind of backwards. So really train yourself to lift up. Your left sits bone is off the floor. You're grounding through your right glute and the top of your right thigh. Wrap your arms around. You can interlace your fingers or bind your wrists. Try to squeeze your back slightly. Lift your chest up and take five deep breaths. The end of your fifth exhale, gently release your leg, and you can either roll forward and step back and lower down, chaturanga, or you can jump back and jump through. So now let's look at a little more advanced variation. If you're able to bring your right foot into half lotus, and that's not too much of a stretch through your shin, bring that right foot up so we're back in starting position. Now, ultimately, we're binding in this pose, so really learn how to bring that knee towards your chest and really wrap your arm around. You can wrap your arm around your knee, or you can take your arm over your knee and bring your right hand to the floor. And we're gonna take five deep breaths. Every inhale, try to lift and lengthen. Every exhale, twist over your right shoulder. Inhale to look forward, exhale to release and take your vinyasa. Coming into our left side, start by bringing your right foot into half lotus, bend your left knee up, either take your arm around or over your bent right knee. But I want you guys to notice, I'm really pulling my knee past midline. So I try to get my arm as deep over my knee as I can. From there, you can bring your left hand to the floor and inhale to lengthen and exhale to rotate. Every inhale as I lengthen, I really try to lift my torso, and every exhale as I rotate, I'm pushing my right arm into my left leg as I twist and rotate to the left. After your fifth deep breath, inhale to look forward, exhale to release, and vinyasa. If you're new to the channel, welcome. Olotita is an ancient Greek word that means wholeness. This channel is based primarily on yoga practices, meditation, nutrition, mindfulness, many different aspects of self-care that combine to create wholeness in your life. And I welcome you to the channel. If you have not already, make sure you subscribe and click that notification bell. There's many ways to work into this pose. I'm gonna show you ways I don't want you to work into it, and then we're gonna look at how it is most appropriate to work into this posture. Bring that left foot into half lotus first. Now, the first thing I wanna address is this knee. When you're trying to bind, a lot of times you'll let the knee float out to the side. It can put a lot of undue pressure on the knee, so it's really nice to squeeze that inner thigh and bring it forward. Then you can use this as a point of balance. From here, really pulling this knee into midline, grounding into your foot. A lot of people start to try to bind from back here, meaning your glutes are grounded on the floor, you're trying to rotate and bind. Now this is a way to bind, but it puts a lot of undue pressure on your shoulders, doesn't it, Miss Lucy? So instead of doing this, try to bring your weight forward so your glute is off the floor, that right glute is off the floor, bring that knee into midline, and then you're working to bring your elbow towards your heel. So as you work to bring your armpit over your knee and your elbow towards your heel, then you can start to rotate your arm under, and if you can clear from here, really shift your weight forward so that you're balancing on your leg. From here, you can reach around and bind your hand. In the full expression, you're trying to grab your thigh, and once you're bound and you're forward, you can start to lengthen up, and it helps to drop that right sits bone down. So you're nice and deep in your bind, and you're perfectly in the posture. Look over your right shoulder and take 5 deep breaths. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, release your bind and take your vinyasa. Starting with your left side, we bring the right foot into half lotus. Make sure the toes are not coming past your thigh. Bring your left foot up and then bring your body weight forward. Remember not to let that leg soften, so try to squeeze your inner thigh. Then pull this left knee over to the right. Keep your left foot grounded. From here, start to work to dig your elbow towards your ankle. And we're working to get that armpit nice and tight around your knee. From here, rotate your arm slightly. And once you clear through your leg, reach your left arm behind you, bind your hands. If you have a nice deep bind, you're gonna take that left hand and grab your inner right thigh. And then from here, you can lengthen up and either stay off of your left glute or sits bone, or you can drop into your left glute and take the posture. After 5 breaths, inhale to look forward, exhale, release. Oh, Miss Lucy, you brought me some food. Thank you, baby girl. And take your vinyasa. Step or jump back to lower down. Inhale to up dog. Exhale, down dog. And walk or step or jump through to seated. Going back to examine the posture one more time, you can easily come into the pose, keeping your knee grounded and your sits bone off the floor. This is my preference for the posture, but you could just as easily, as we did last time, drop that sits bone and the knee is slightly lifted. It's completely up to you what you would prefer to do. This posture takes a lot of time and effort. If you have not mastered Marichyasana B, the other half lotus posture, you're not gonna master this one. That's one of the reasons why in Ashtanga Yoga it's so powerful to truly physically master the poses that come before, because they prepare you for the poses that come next. So if you're working through this posture and you're like, gosh, this is so intense of a stretch, think about going back to this variation to open up the hip, to take pressure off of the knee. Think about even working with the very first variation where you're lifting up, keeping that foot into half lotus and just kind of sitting tall. It's gonna train the tissue on the shin and the top of the foot to lengthen and open. Then this part becomes the only real challenge. And if you are doing your practice consistently, this is even not gonna be that hard. But if rotation is really hard, you might find that you can't even get any further than this. Practice, practice, practice. If you are brand new to the channel and you're just digging your feet into the yoga asana series, do start back at the very beginning with our first yoga asana video posted around January of 2022, and then slowly build your way up through each tutorial video until you get to Marīcyāsana D. If your weight is over your left leg, if you're pulling your body weight forward, remember gravity is working with and against us, so use gravity to your advantage. If you're a student who's trying real hard to bind back here, it's very difficult to get the bind because then you're falling backwards. So literally lift your body weight up and forward and then try to make yourself really small. And I often will push my hand into my thigh to help give me some leverage. You want to clear that armpit over your knee. You can use the weight of your hand to balance your weight. And once you clear through your leg, it's literally a matter of shifting your weight into your left leg and binding. Bringing your right foot into half lotus. Always check your foot position. Bring that left foot up. Shift your body weight forward. If this is hard, just work with that for a while. Then we're pulling that knee to center and past center, and I'm taking my armpit over my knee. All my body weight is still forward. Even my head is forward. I'm leaning forward. Take my left hand behind me. Get my arm all the way through, shift my weight forward so I'm balancing on my right leg, and when I bind, then I can begin to lift up, but I'm nice and tight in my bind. Every inhale, think of squeezing your right arm around your left knee, and every exhale, think of gently pushing your left knee out to the left or into your right arm. And this is gonna help you open and rotate even more. After your fifth breath, you inhale to look forward, exhale, release, and take your vinyasa. I love the Ashtanga Yoga system because it's really important in this practice that we master the poses we're working with before we move on to the next postures. Not only is it safe for our body, it helps us open up and prepare us for what's next, but truly, if you master the poses that you're working on, you're easily able to begin to functionally move into the postures that come after. I hope you had fun looking at some of the variations for starting to work your body into this very unique and intricate posture. I cannot stress enough, please protect your knees. If you find that you're not quite ready for half lotus, please work with some of the variations provided, not just in today's video, but in Marichyasana B video, Marichyasana A video, and Marichyasana C video. They're all great tips for helping not only to work to rotate your body in space, but to also open up your hips and your pelvis so you can safely and more easily get into half lotus positions. Our tradition teaches students to practice 6 days a week, to take off the new and the full moon days. If you're a woman, to take the first few days of what we call your ladies' holiday or your menstrual cycle, and make sure you take rest at least 1 day a week. But if you're dabbling in yoga, the fastest way to really accelerate the growth of your practice, whether it's strength or endurance or flexibility or stamina, is truly just to be consistent with getting to your mat and doing the practice. If you are local, please feel free to join us any weekday for morning Mysore practice right in Winter Park, Florida. I also teach workshops all around the country, so maybe you can pop into one of those soon. Today, I want to talk about the weighted dinosaur plush. They're made from huggable materials that meet the highest international standards. They're mother-to-child grade materials, skin-friendly, durable, washable construction for easy cleaning that stays soft even after countless hugs, bedtime cuddles, anxiety, and stress relief. They're filled with high quality soft PP cotton and recyclable ceramic stones, which I really love because I don't like plastic and there is no plastic in these beautiful, squeezable, huggable toys. Suitable for both children and adults. While they might look super cute for kids, I really do love this. The small dino is 16 inches, weighs 1.6 pounds, and the larger dino, he's 24 inches and he weighs 3.5 pounds. I love the weight of these dinosaurs. Unlike other light products, these weighted plush dinosaurs are designed heavily for real weighted touch. They're great for stress relief. Not only is it such soft cotton, it has a heavy bottom, which is great for hugging and relieve anxiety and stress. These guys are among the top bestsellers for toys and games. And the best part, you can purchase these dinos on Amazon. I'll put a link in the description box below for you to either get the little dino or 16 incher or the 24 inch dino. They make incredible gifts and right now they're 5% off on Amazon. So be sure to grab yours today.